Welcome back to Intuo Focus. In this episode, we will quickly go over sidechain compression and the benefits when applying it. Sidechain compression, also known as ducking, can be used in many different ways. It's a great way to tighten up your mix or to add some extra groove to your music. One common use of it is within electronic dance music because of the consistent beat and rhythm of the kick drum, in other words known as four on the floor. Here's an example of sidechain compression when applied and not applied. The sidechain compression is being applied to the main melody, but being triggered by the kick drum. So every time the kick hits, the melody will duck and slowly come back up in volume. This causes a pumping effect, which essentially provides more rhythm and groove to the music. It's also creating space for both elements, allowing them to stand out at the same time and not compete against one another, which often results into a cleaner mix. Sidechain compression makes sure a specific sound or instrument is compressed, parallel to other sounds in the mix. BeatMaker 3 makes it very simple to apply sidechain compression. In the mix window, select the source which will be compressed. Now go to the Audio Effects tab, tap Add Audio Effect, and select the Dynamics Processor. Leave the mode on Compressor, go to Sidechain Input, and now select the source which will trigger the compressor. In this example, it will be the kick drum. The threshold dictates the level that the compression kicks in. Ratio determines how much compression is applied to a signal that goes over the threshold. The attack is how quickly the compressor engages and reduces the volume of the audio. Release is how long it takes the compressor to disengage and return the audio to its normal level. You also have the option to change the mode to a limiter or an expander. A limiter serves as a ceiling, which a signal cannot pass. Expanders increase the difference in loudness between quieter and louder sections of audio, making quiet sounds quieter and loud sounds louder. First, let's adjust the ratio and threshold parameters until we get the sound that we want. You'll notice in this square window, we have a visual representation of what's happening to our audio. You can then further tweak the sound to your likings with the other parameters in the compressor. This is just one example on how sidechain compression can be utilized. Again, it can be used in a variety of different ways, and the purpose of applying it will vary with what you're trying to execute. Now that you know how to apply sidechain compression within BeatMaker 3, I highly suggest trying it out, experiment with different ideas, and see other ways it can be utilized. Before we wrap this up, here's another example applying the same technique but to a different genre of music. Hope you found this helpful. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next one.